Well, hello everybody. I'm finally back. Sorry for my absence. I am going to let this video run for just a bit, and then I'll come back in and explain what's going on and how we're doing. But a lot of you have asked, and I appreciate that. So let me just run this a little bit, and then I'll come back and talk with you. Okay, I know most of you remember this video, and a lot of you made comments, and rightly so, about, you know, getting help and so on and so forth. And this was a big mistake on my part, obviously, thinking that I could do more than I actually could. My mind tells me I'm 22. My body says I'm 70. So I've got to start realizing that. And Jocelyn saw this, and After a couple weeks, when we saw this, we sat down and talked, and we decided that I just can't continue to do this type of work. I can't do it alone, and you know, it needs to be. I need to have help doing it. However, we're not going to try to solicit help anywhere. Come spring, I'll get with the family and see if they want me to maintain it. But at this point, I've got it trimmed down and cut down as much as I can do. The rest of it is pretty good sized limbs and tree work and all that. And I'm just not willing anymore or able anymore to do that stuff. Number one, I don't blame anyone for this fall or anything. I don't blame anyone for anything. Sorry, I had to pause that. The inspector's behind me here in his window, and he saw a couple dogs, somebody walking a couple dogs, and he was getting a little excited. So, but anyway, I don't blame anyone for anything that I did for this fall or anything. However, I think at this, I injured my wrist here. I'm pretty sure this is where I did it. My wrist, I can't put any pressure on it at all, and even trying to run a weed eater at my own home has been a problem. I don't know if it was here or if I did it somewhere else, but at any rate, I also, my left hip, my left shoulder, which I've known for a few years now that I'm facing surgery on getting a shoulder replacement. And, you know, shortly, a few weeks after this, my shoulder started to bother me. I don't know if it was when the weather cooled down or what, but again, I don't blame anybody or anything. It's just that I know that I'm faced with this surgery on my shoulder replacement. I've been putting it off for quite a while. In fact, I may have mentioned it in a video, but the doctor told me, the orthopedic surgeon told me that the last time I went in about a year and a half ago, he said, I'm going to give you one more steroid shot, but that's it for the steroid shots. Next visit is the shoulder replacement because it's shot. And it's gotten to the point now as it's gotten colder, keeps me up at night, wakes me up in bed and all that. Anyway, along with that, I have neglected a lot of things around my house that I didn't realize I was even neglecting. First and foremost, Miss Jocelyn, you know, when I leave here at 7:30 in the morning, and I only go over there and work a couple 3 hours, and then by the time I clean up and get home and unload and everything, you know, it's been 4 or 5 hours and I'm gone. And it's not fair to her that I do that, because then when I do come home, I'm just beat and I don't feel like doing anything else. That's not fair to her. She's never once complained. She's always supported me. And that's why I love this woman. She's a one in a million. But I realized over the last month or two that I've been neglecting a lot of things in the home, maintenance-wise, and with my family here, with the inspector and with Harper and Miss Jocelyn, especially Miss Jocelyn. So I'm not going to continue to try to do the work over at this property because, like I said, it's gotten to the point back there where it's mostly bigger limbs and tree limbs and cutting and chipping and all that. And all those things are pretty tough to do. You know, I can go over and weed eat for a while, you know, once I get my hand looked at, or not looked at, but fixed. And we don't know if we're going to do surgery. Right now it's physical therapy. But at any rate, you know, I'm 70 years old, almost 71 now, so life happens. I am not leaving YouTube. I'm going to continue to post videos. I'll do the river. And I've gone through my shop that I haven't done in a year, and I've, you know, cleaned up and set up my machines again, and I'm going to start turning wood again, and I'll post some videos from time to time of that. It might not be as exciting to you folks that like the lawn care or the yard makeover videos, but I'm going to keep putting them up anyway. If you want to watch them, great. If not, that's great too. And also I have a metal lathe and a metal milling machine, and I have some projects lined up for that. And we're going to be, you know, spending time at the river, you know, getting things tidied up there. And coming up here shortly in this video is a video of our little boat. I think I told you about it. It's a rigid inflatable boat, very nice boat. And I've got a video coming up here of me getting a trailer all set up and getting the boat on the trailer. So anyway, there's the inspector. Let me let this run for just a little bit, and I will come back in just a couple minutes. Well, there's our little boat. I'm not gonna buy an expensive boat at this stage of my life. This is gonna be perfect for us. I'll put a little bimini, which is a little canopy, on it, and it's very, very strong. It's it's not one of these that you blow up by mouth. It's got a foot pump there, but it takes a lot to blow it up, and it's very heavy. The floor is all aluminum, hard floor, and it's got the transom there that's hardened. And that holds anything up to a 40-horsepower motor. I only have a small 6-horsepower outboard, which is plenty for us. So I bought this trailer at Harbor Freight. It's just a little utility trailer, and I built a flat deck on it. And before I put the carpeting on, which is coming up next, I had this this tarp that I laid on there, and I used that to drag it off. So anyway... But it's a good boat. It's plenty big enough for us, and it's deep. It's not like a little John boat. It's got high sides, and it's heavy, and very good boat. It can go anywhere. I mean, you know, if you want to go in the ocean with this, you can. It's not limited to little ponds or little lakes or anything like that. So I think we'll enjoy it. But getting back to our decision, you know, as much as I hate to, I won't admit defeat, but I'm disappointed that I can't get the entire job done. I have reached out to a couple of tree guys that I know and asked if they'd be interested in doing any volunteer type work, and I'll go over there and I won't supervise, but I'll go over there and just be there when they do it. But I'm not going to get involved in it right now, not with a bad shoulder and with this wrist I got to get fixed up first. But and you people have all told me that. My faithful followers have told me time and time and time again to get help, and that trying to move that couch, and that's not the only thing I did. I've taken a few falls over there that I didn't video, but nothing major, nothing that hurt me. So anyway, unfortunately, I won't be doing any makeover videos at this point, not right now anyway. I don't know what'll happen in the spring and next year, but if we change our mind, and I'll get back into it. But I'll have to talk with the family and just let them know that, you know, what I'm doing, what I'm not doing, and go from there. I feel good about what I've done with their property to this point, but I just can't continue. And I hope you all understand. I can't thank you enough for your support on this channel. I'm going to continue to post some videos, the river, and me and the inspector and Jocelyn, and other things, because as my channel name says, it's Tom's Simple Life. It's not all about yard care and lawn makeovers. I've got my yard and my neighbor's yard. He's in a bad physical way, so he can't really do much. So I got our two yards to do, and that's enough for me at this point. Jocelyn and I spent about 3 weeks going through our house, just doing minor paint touch-ups and minor repairs and things that I have just neglected and felt horrible about as I was doing them, saying, I can't believe I let this go so long. And I don't blame anybody for that. That's my own stubborn self. So I'm going to devote my time to my home, my family, and I'm also going to continue doing. I love woodworking, and I have a wood lathe, and I have a metal lathe and a milling machine. I love doing that stuff. So I'll post some of those videos, and if people enjoy it, great. Please watch. If not, then I totally understand. But once again, I want to thank everyone from the bottom of my heart, and so does Jocelyn, for your support through this past year, through this project. You folks have been unbelievably kind to me. I've had a few that are negative comments, but good Lord, the number of positive so far outweighs any few negative that I don't even remember them. So anyway, I will see you again soon. I'm actually working on something out in the shop now, but we're going to be going down the river soon, and I'll get some video of that and see whenever we get the boat in the water and things like that. But once again, folks, thank you from the bottom of my heart. I'm not just bailing out, but I've made a decision, we've made a decision, that I just can't continue in this line of work. I've got to realize that enough's enough for me. So thanks again, folks. Love you all. Keep the comments coming if you don't mind, and we'll continue to post some videos and talk to you and let you know what's going on in our lives. You're part of our family, so we're not going to just leave you high and dry. Thanks again, folks. I'm going to go to the hospital.